Come on in. Healing potion. Speciality here, should you need any.
Avelio.
What can I do for you today? A wise decision. Thank you. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Ravenia. Revelio. Ravenia. Revelio. Ravenia. Revelio.
You're back! Nice to see you again. That item is of the highest quality. You'll be thrilled with that broom, I promise you. Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again.
Revelio.
Hello there. Come on in. Plenty to look at here.
Revelio.
Let's look at what we have, shall we? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Ha!
Revelio. Revelio.
Nothing to poach in Arranger except spot.
Quiet the mouth, Randy. Can't say I mind.
What do you have in store for me this time?
Pointless. No one comes through here.
Revelio. Revelio.
Thank you.
Perhaps I shall scout around Fellcroft for something to poach. Someone's... I'm sure it'd be harder to kill a moon calf.
Production! No! Hang on! And I haven't even had me ten fingers! Lumos. Lumos. That. These rocks have seen better days.
See if there's something you need. Thank you for your patronage. It's been a pleasure.
What seems to be the problem?
You may well ask. I'm convinced I saw a Grim, an omen of death. I'm not safe, but if it can't see me, I'll be all right, won't I? All I need is an invisibility potion. Yes, that's what I need.
Well, as it happens, I have what you need. Here. Not sure it'll help you, though. Be careful, won't you?
Oh, you're a gem, you are. I'll be sure to be very careful. And you be careful, too. No Grim is going to get me. Thanks to you, kind child. I must insist that you accept this small token of me gratitude for your thoughtfulness.
Revelio.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
roaches. Garniff was right then. I'd better be careful. Incendio!
You can't keep your eyes off a pretty lass, you can't. Quit a flick of a frock and you fall to pieces.
Not especially quiet, are you? Someone there.
Something's not right here. You'd better
show yourself.
Look as to tell us. Hello, Hamora. Point Leviosa, Glacius, Brass of Momentum. Revelio. Now, I'm only trying to help. Get you back to Garnov, shall we? Leviosa! Everything's all right now. Revelio. Thank you. Velio. Are you in some sort of trouble?
Nearly attacked by wolves, I was. Only just escaped with my life. I need to be better prepared next time. Could use some thunder brew. I don't suppose a student like yourself would be in possession of such a thing?
Yes, I have some right here. Please, take it. And be careful.
Oh, thank you! Thank you! I knew you had a good heart. I feel better already just knowing I have some thunder brew on hand.
Are you in some sort of trouble?
Nearly attacked by wolves, I was. Only just escaped with my life. I need to be better prepared next time. Could use some thunder brew. I don't suppose a student like yourself would be in possession of such a thing?
Yes, I have some right here. Please, take it. And be careful.
Oh, thank you! Thank you! I knew you had a good heart. I feel better already just knowing I have some thunder brew on hand.
See if there's something you need. That's been a pleasure. Pleased to see our...
You fret, Biscuit. I shall sort some...
Garneth, I've rescued Biscuit.
You have? Oh, is she hurt? Was she frightened? Are you all right?
Biscuit is fine, as am I. I was able to rescue her without much incident.
Oh, mercy. Where poachers are concerned, I tend to expect the worst. I cannot wait to get her home. I so miss seeing her dance in the evenings. Such joy.
I'm glad she's safe now. I'm sure she'll be happy to go home.
Oh, that is a great weight off my mind. Oh, my sweet little Biscuit. My wise, noble moon calf. And here is your reward, of course. Well deserved. As I said before, you have restored my faith in wizardkind. You've restored at least a modicum of my faith in wizardkind. Oh, Biscuit and I can't thank you enough.
Revelio.
Here we found a bit of treasure in the forest.
Deke thinks you should be. The potions you've brewed.
There. I'm not going to hurt you. Professor Howen will never believe this. Revelio. Revelio. I'd like to ask you about changing the room's ambiance.
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
I'd like the room to be warm and comfortable, as if I'm floating inside a mug of butterbeer.
Oh, sounds perfect.
And your reading is the dragon. That's exciting, I suppose. Perhaps you're due for an adventure.
Ladies?
Professor Shah.
Astronomy is not divination. You won't find the mysteries of the cosmos charted out on your palms or at the bottom of your teacups. Alas, the heavens remain hazy to the starry-eyed. Now, if you were to devote yourselves to persistent and painstaking observation, you just might catch a glimpse. With that in mind, please take your telescopes. Tonight we will be on the observation deck. Still don't have your own? You can't be the new student forever, you know. You can share with Mr. Takar.
Here, I can adjust that for
you. No, bring it into focus on your own. Now, I expect all of you to put in your stargazing hours outside of class. Is that clear?
But, Professor, it's freezing out.
Mere cold didn't stop the great stargazers of the past. Look only to the astronomy tables they erected throughout the Highlands from which they gazed millennia ago on the very selfsame stars above us. Is that clear? Dismissed.
Hello. I don't believe we've met officially. I'm Amit. I'm something of an astronomy buff.
Hello, Amit. It's nice to meet you.
Did I hear Professor Shaw say that you don't have your own telescope? I have a spare one you could borrow for the rest of term.
That's very kind of you, Amit. Are you sure you won't need it?
I'm certain. It's my old one. I finally got my hands on the new Celestia Contemplor. You've heard of it, I assume? I mean, of course you have. It's only the pinnacle of all personal stargazing implements. But my old model's not too shabby either. Goblin-cut glass, first-rate optical enchantments. Hate to think such a fine instrument is just collecting dust.
Well, I... Thank you, Amit.
Think nothing of it. Anyway, the telescope's in the storage room right underneath us. You can't miss it. I have some, reading to finish on the lower deck. Come find me there afterwards and bring the telescope. There's something I want to talk to you about.
Revelio.
Tried to put off my stargazing as long as I could.
Professor Shah's just about as cold and distant as the bloody stars she wants us to chart. Not how I wanted to spend my evening.
Not sure what you can learn from these astronomy tables that you can't learn from a cup of tea leaves.
Almeet thinks he knows everything. Even told me he can speak gobbledygook. Sounded like gibberish to me.
The constellations are beautiful. Not sure they're worth dying of a cold for, but they are beautiful.
This was his old telescope. Looks practically brand new. Revelio.
A pristine night for stargazing. Do not let it be wasted.
Professor Shaw, I'm interested in learning more about astronomy.
It is increasingly rare to find a student who seeks after things celestial, of their own accord. But if you truly desire to chart the courses of the cosmos, you must rid your mind of the terrestrial babble of others. We ourselves are not unlike blank star charts, you know? Empty canvases waiting to be inscribed with all that the universe has to offer. Do you understand?
Am I right in thinking you are unimpressed by divination?
Of the many other so-called disciplines taught here, divination is perhaps the most feeble, especially in its nonsensical practice of astrology. Do not confuse astronomy and astrology. One is concerned with mysteries stellar and lunar. The other is mere lunacy.
You mentioned astronomy tables earlier in class. What were you talking about?
Long ago, devotees of the astral arts set up stone slabs across the countryside. They are ideal for studying constellations near and far. For centuries, wizards made use of these astronomy tables for stargazing. Sadly, they have since become mere monuments to the intrepid intellectual pursuits of a bygone epoch.
Thank you, Professor. I look forward to stargazing.
I am glad to hear it. Should be a stellar night for it.
The perfect night for...
I have the telescope. It's nicer than I had expected.
I would not offer a prospective stargazer a third-rate lunascope. But there is, something else.
Yes? What is it?
You remember those astronomy tables Shaw was going on about? It just so happens I've been reading up on them a little myself. And it seems there may be one right here at Hogwarts. I believe we could use it to find hidden constellations.
And you need someone to help you find it.
I do. Are you in? No one from the Gobstones Club will go with me. Said they'd rather get spit at by a stone than... Well, they are cowards. Let us get moving while the stars are still out. I'll show you how to use that telescope once we get there. I promise.
Oh, no need to convince me. Let's get going.
Brilliant. You won't regret it. Shall we? The table is on a castle wall ahead. Look for a stone platform, something that doesn't quite belong. We'll know it when we see it. Onwards we go. Some say the locations of the tables were originally marked by centaurs for ritual stargazing.
Rebellion.
Gobstones Club are cowards.
Revelio. A few cobwebs and dust. Nothing to be concerned about.
Oh, of course. It's just not as tidy as I expected. Cobwebs. You don't think any spiders might be lurking about?
Oh, no. Not this close to the school, Emmett.
The constellation should appear near the center of your view. I was right about the tables. They really are gateways to the far stars, just as the book said. And your contribution was invaluable. Rest assured, you shall be credited in my memoirs one day.
Thank you, Emmett. I look forward to reading them.
And I look forward to writing them. This is only the beginning. You will find more tables like this one throughout the grounds and forest, all beckoning to be discovered by a worthy astronomer. And if I have ever seen one, it's you. Oh, and about my old telescope. Don't bother returning it. You should keep it.
That's quite generous. Thank you.
You are welcome. It has goblin-cut glass and a gobbledygook inscription. I'm practically fluent in gobbledygook, you know. It's all in the throat, really, gobbledygook, you know, and how you pronounce your R's. Anyway, glad our adventure was a success. I will see you soon. What an excellent...
Revelio.
Thank you.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Wingardium Leviosa. Lumos. Revelio. Alohomora. Let me Elio. Alohomora. Mind now, demiguys. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. 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 Thank you.
mother's rolling
in... Pardon me, sir.
Come to stare at the fool, have you? There's poor Ig Haggerty, robbed by his own sister. She's robbed almost everyone now. So, who's the fool?
I'm not sure I know what you're talking about.
Then you're the only one who doesn't know about Katrin running off with that thief, Victor Rookwood and his lot. Good riddance, I said. Never thought she'd return to steal from me. Us. But I just know it was her. I want her caught and sent to Azkaban for stealing a prized family heirloom. Sister or no.
Are you sure Katrin is the culprit? It could be anyone.
Thanks to that Rookwood louse, we're inundated with all manner of criminal. I wanted to believe it was any one of them except Katrin. But she was the only one who knew where the heirloom was hidden, and she knew precisely which homes to rob.
Why would Katrin come back to rob the hamlet if she'd already left?
Do I look like a criminal to you? How should I know? She always despised this place, resented having to grow up here. Perhaps she did it to spite us.
What exactly was the family heirloom that the thief stole?
A necklace. Belonged to the first of the Haggerty women. Hundreds of years old. So much history. She'll likely pawn it.
I could keep an eye out for the thief, sir.
You? Ugh. Nothing to be done by the likes of us. This is a job for the fine officer singer or some such authority. Besides, the thief... My sister only strikes at night. Coward. Long past your bedtime.
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? I'd keep an eye on your belongings if I were you. Katrin will steal the eyebrow. Your face, she will.
I ought to look into this thievery business for Mr. Haggerty once night falls. Here we are. Mr. Weeks wasn't wrong about the mountain views.
If it isn't the fastest Hufflepuff.
Hello, Melda. So, another trial?
Of course it's another trial. And you'd better be taking part.
Does this mean you've changed your mind about me?
Well, you're a step up from the good-for-nothings who usually challenge me. Well, they sit around and hope to be the best. I put in hours of practice. No one sets records by wishing for them. And I need strong competition to stay on top of my game. Are you going to try to beat my flying record or not?
Strong competition? Could that have been a compliment, Imelda?
Go ahead, believe what you want. Makes no difference. Compliments make people soft. No one goes round telling me I did a fine job. Do I care? No. I say I'm the best, and that's all I need. So please, try to beat my record, fifth year, and don't be disappointed when you lose.
I'm ready to fly.
Finally, a decent challenge.
I'd say that was acceptable.
Oh.
getting the hang of this. Brilliant.
You've improved, I must admit. That was a bloody good run. Be careful. Earn a reputation for talent around here, and some people get put out about it.
Sounds like you're speaking from experience.
Yes, well, I am. Anyway, you didn't do abysmally. I can't deny that. But you'll not have the same luck on the South Coast course.
You said your reputation for talent put some people out. Like whom?
If you must know, I've had to deal with jealousy from members of my own house. When we were first years, Nerida Roberts and I spent loads of time on our brooms, pledged to fly every day. As my skill on a broom grew, rapidly I might add, Nerida suddenly didn't have time for flying practice. I tried to give her pointers, but she didn't have the natural ability I did. Clearly, she was jealous. Poor thing spends all her time now dawdling by the lake, obsessed with merpeople. Won't even learn to swim. I refuse to downplay my talents to coddle someone else's fragile ego. Anyway, I need to ready the next course. Stop by when it's ready, if you can handle it.
We'll see, won't we? Till next time.
I half expected you to back down. Rest on your laurels. See you at the South Coast trial, if you don't lose your nerve. To race this course again, visit the podium with the leaderboard, where you can start the race and check your time.
Another successful flight. I should let Mr. Weeks know. Revelio.
Never knows when society will be frozen.
Now that it's night, I ought to look into this thievery business for Mr. Haggerty. Revelio.
Would lead someone to treasure.
Revelio. More gold. I must be getting closer.
Probably I can get my hands on Fig or that student. I know I heard something that time.
Revelio.
Is somebody there? Hello?
I know a Merlin trial when I see one. After all, Merlin. Revelio. Revelio. This looks intriguing.
Up for a bit of dying, are we? What's that? Who's there? What was that? So I'm not alone. What?
Hello?
You're so very weak. Are you quite finished? That was unimpressive.
I won't rest.
Revelio. A Niffler. It wasn't Catherine Haggerty after all. Revelio. For the Haggerty family heirloom. Revelio. That must be the Haggerty family heirloom. I'm safe to explore in there. Lumos. Abandoned long ago, no doubt. Revelio. Lumos. Mysterious and a bit unsettling. What to do? I have some good news, Mr. Haggerty. I unmasked your thief.
Nothing to unmask, was there? We all know that the thief was my sister, Catherine.
Actually, sir, the thief was a niffler.
A what?
You know, small, furry, pilfering. I followed it to its lair.
Catelyn was the only one who knew how to get into our homes, where to find our treasures. But I suppose, mangy little blighter. Well, if you found a niffler's lair, as you say, you must have found my heirloom.
As a matter of fact, I did.
Thank you. You don't know how much this means to me. Catherine's a disappointment for certain, but I never wanted to believe she was behind this. Now, thanks to you, I won't have to. What a strange world we live in. Suppose they can't send a niffler to Azkaban.
Revelio. Revelio. Incendio! Revelio.